Hello, and thank you for stopping by Shaping Your World with Sha. If this is your first time here, welcome. And if you've been here before, thanks so much for coming back again. If you like what you see here, I hope that you will subscribe. And if you do choose to subscribe, make sure to hit that like button and the bell notification so that you never miss an upload here on this channel. Today we're going to be talking about Mielle Organics products, specifically from the Pomegranate and Honey line. I washed my hair, so I have freshly washed hair. I just washed it and put it into two twists, and I'm going to be trying out their curl refreshing spray, the leave-in conditioner, and the twisting souffle. And again, this is from Mielle Organics, and it's these products are specifically from the Pomegranate and Honey collection. I did wash my hair with their with products from the Rosemary Mint Strengthening collection. So I used the Rosemary Mint Strengthening shampoo, and I followed that with the Rosemary Mint Strengthening hair mask. I used these two products, washed my hair, and I just put the hair into two twists, put the towel on it so that it could air dry. And now we're going to, I'm gonna get into styling. So don't mind my nails, that's gonna come after. I'm gonna be doing my manicure later. So please don't mind them at all, they're a hot mess. But just to recap, I'm gonna be using the curl refreshing spray because now that I've let my hair air dry, it does need to be dampened. So I'm gonna use the curl refreshing spray to dampen it. And I'm gonna follow that up with the leave-in conditioner just to, you know, prep the hair for the styling. And then I'm gonna be using the twisting souffle as my styler. So I've never used these products before. I have used the Rosemary Mint Strengthening Shampoo. I've been using that for a number of years. I'll say maybe like five or six years now. I really like that shampoo. This is my first time using the hair mask. I do, as you can see, I have very thin edges. My hairline is very thin, so I'm just hoping that maybe the hair mask will help me with that. But it smells really nice. It's got that rosemary mint smell, so you know, if you're not a fan of rosemary or mint, then you know, you might not like that part. But I will say, it's not like I'm moving my hair around and the smell is not overwhelming me. So I am very sensitive to scents. I have a very sensitive nose. And I don't find that it's a scent that would bother me. If you're not a fan of mint or you're not a fan of rosemary, don't let that put you off. So I'm just gonna give the curl refreshing spray a little shake. And how about, there's probably some way to, okay, so I figured out you have to press this little, so there's a little white button here, and this is the locking mechanism. So you just have to press it to be able to spray. This smells really good. And again, this is their Pomegranate and Honey line. I like this. And I'm just gonna smooth that in. Oh, it smells really nice. Again, like I said, my hair is towel dried right now, so it is giving it some nice moisture. Okay. And as you can see, I like to section my hair off. So right now it's just in the two sections, but when I'm styling my hair, I like to section it. I like to work in four sections. So right now I'm just gonna part this side into two. And I'm gonna just do a little bantu knot to get the front out of the way. Now particularly to the ends. Make sure I get up in the inside. And I'm gonna rake that through so that my hair is getting thoroughly saturated by the product. I have, like most people, I have very combination hair. So different sections of my hair has different textures. Here in the back, it's extremely coily. So it's really important that I get all of the strands saturated with any product that I'm using. Otherwise, my styling will be very uneven, which nobody likes. You know, the parts, if I neglect to cover every strand or all the parts of the section, I'll have frizzy patches. So just try to, you know, thoroughly rake my fingers through, and as you can see, it's going through with ease, no problem with detangling. And I do detangle while I'm in the shower. I did that before I created the two twists that I had. So now I'm gonna just apply the leave-in conditioner. Okay, so I'm applying this much. I've never used these products before, so I don't know like what's the proper amount to use. I mean, obviously there are instructions on the bottle, but again, I have my hair is really different. And I find that a lot of times, even if a product has instructions that say to use like a dime or a quarter size, that's just never enough for my hair, because again, I have I have to make sure that every single strand is being covered. So I'm just going between shingling and raking, and definitely coating the edges, just making sure that goes through there. And okay, so that looks pretty good so far, and hopefully we don't dry flaky. And that, obviously, that's definitely a risk that I run into a lot of times, because I'm heavy-handed with my product. I do sometimes get flaking, but I'm definitely, in today's video, I'm just gonna go through doing the twists, and I will come back in another video in a few days to show you the takedown of the twist, and we'll do that together and see what we're looking like. So, okay, there's that. And again, so far we've used the leave-in conditioner and the curl refreshing spray and the leave-in conditioner from the Mielle Organics Pomegranate and Honey line. So now we're gonna go in with the twisting souffle. So I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna take a little bit, take this much. And I'm gonna do a combination of shingling and raking, just to get the hair saturated. And as you can see, it's going through very smoothly. I don't use combs or brushes on my hair. I just use my fingers, and it's going through really nicely, really, really nicely. Okay. So now I'm gonna start with my twisting. And normally I would like to part from the bottom and work my way up, but I don't have my clips here with me right now. So because I don't have my clips, I'm gonna start from the top and work my way down, and that way I can move the twist out of the way as I go along. My hair is parted. I have a side part. It's kind of high. It doesn't really look so much like a side part. It is kind of closer to the middle than a traditional side part, but it's kind of a side part. And I say that because there's less hair on this side than there is on this side. So for these, I can do one twist per row. When I get to this side, I'll be doing two twists per row. So, and what I mean by one twist per row is, as you saw, I did a section. I sectioned off some hair, and I'm doing one twist. If this section were bigger, I would have done, I would have taken this section of hair and split it in two, so that the twist wouldn't be too big. But I just twist, and when I get to the end, I just do the little coil, and we're gonna move this out of the way. And now we're gonna go, I'm gonna section off another piece, give it a little rake through to make sure the area is coated, and give that a twist. And the product, again, the smell is, it's a little more intense than the rosemary mint, but it's, again, nothing too overwhelming. I am in my bathroom. I don't have the air on. So if the product were, if the fragrance were overwhelming, I would definitely be feeling it because I don't have the air on right now, but I'm not having any issue with that. I'm gonna move that one out of the way, and one more. And I'm gonna do this last one here on camera with you, and then I'm gonna finish the rest of my head off camera and come back to you when my whole head is twisted. So this is the last twist I'm gonna do in this section, and just like my everyday makeup, when I do my everyday twist outs, I try not to spend a whole lot of time. I try to make this process as quick as possible. So now I have the three twists here. And I'm gonna go to this side, and I'm gonna do the same thing on this side. I'll split it in two. Well, first I'll apply the refresher, curl refresher. I'll split it into, and the leave-in conditioner, split it in two, work on the back section and work on the front section. And I'll get back to you when I'm done with that. Okay, so actually I was applying the leave-in conditioner to the front, and I decided to come back on camera to show you how much different this front section of my hair is from the back section. So as you saw, the back section of my hair was very coily, whereas my front, the texture in the front is way looser. So sometimes I run into issues with my styles, not because there's any, not due to any fault of the products themselves, but just because of the huge difference in the textures of my hair. So, I mean, ideally I should be using completely different products on different sections of my head, but I really don't have patience for that. If I maybe had an event to go to, or you know, had some special occasion, I would take the time for that. But right now I'm just doing a regular twist out because I washed my hair, and you know, I want it to just keep it healthy as possible. So we don't have any events coming up this week, so I don't need any, like, you know, specific style, or you know, if my hair doesn't come out ideal, it's not a problem. So anyway, I'm going to go ahead and twist this section, and I'll come back when my whole head is done. Hello, so I'm back. So I'm on my last twist here. And I really like the consistency of the custard. It's, I'm sorry, souffle. The twisting souffle, it has a nice consistency. As you can see, it's not so white anymore. That's fading in, so I shouldn't experience any issue with flaking. And I anticipate that this side, even though it's still white now, that will go away like it's doing over here. I like to take, when I'm finished, take the excess and just smooth my hair down. Smooth my hairline, just so I'm not wasting product, just washing it off my hands. But yeah, so today we used 5 Mielle organic products in all. We used 2 from the Rosemary Mint Strengthening line, which I used the Rosemary Mint Strengthening Shampoo along with the Rosemary Mint Strengthening Hair Mask to wash and decondition my hair. I let it air dry with a towel wrapped around it. And then for styling, I used from Pomegranate and Honey Vine, the Curl Refreshing Spray, followed by the Leave-in Conditioner, and then styled with the Twisting Soufflé. And what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna leave these twists in my hair for a few days, at least until tomorrow. And then I will come back at some point this week with my review of how the products worked as far as this particular twist out is concerned. And I did buy products from some of her other lines. Mielle Organics had their anniversary sale where they had all of their products on their website for $5.99. So I took advantage of that promotion and I ordered different lines that I had always wanted to try. Prior to this anniversary sale, my only experience with Mielle Organics products was with the mint, Rosemary Mint Strengthening line. And also, I've had this mint almond oil. This is really old. Please forgive how terrible the bottle looks. And I don't even think she uses this packaging anymore. But I've been using the almond oil for many, many, many years. And in fact, I will use the almond oil when I take down my twists. So the almond oil I've been using for a long time. The Rosemary Mint Strengthening Shampoo I've been using for a long time. But all of the other products that I'm going to be reviewing in the coming weeks are all new to me. So I'm really excited to see what my thoughts are on them. And I'm here to share those thoughts with you and we'll grow as a community. You let me know if you've tried any of Mielle Organics products. If you have, which lines of hers do you prefer? Whether the Rosemary Mint Strengthening line, the Pomegranate and Honey line. She's got a Hawaiian Ginger line, which I also purchased some products from. So let me know your thoughts, if you've what your experience have been with the products and with the brand overall. I do really think I like the brand. It's a Black-owned brand. If you're not aware, Mielle Organics is a Black-owned brand, and it was started by a Black woman who is an RN. And when I come back with my thoughts on these products, I'll make sure to have more information about the founder of Mielle Organics in that video as well. So I hope that you will come back and watch that video. And like I said, you know, if you like what you saw here today, please do subscribe. Hit that like bell, that like button, and don't forget to turn on the bell notification so that you will never miss an upload from me. Thanks again for stopping by Shaping Your World with Shaw, and I hope to see you soon. Take care. Bye-bye.